Well, the first chapter is called Loss. It starts in July 1949, when the lawyers handed me to my parents. The medical community believed that a newborn baby was essentially a blank slate, with no particular memory or feelings. My birth mother's emotional health was of no importance, and it was general policy not to provide the adoptive parents with any medical information. Social workers did their best to match the coloring and features of the baby with that of the parents. And in my case, they did a really good job. I looked a lot like my adoptive mother, but my temperament and interests definitely came from another pond. Needless to say, in spite of the common belief, it appeared that I wasn't about to be fooled. My parents might have been elated to receive me, and my family members shared in the joy, but at 3 days old, I was inconsolable. The day they brought me home, my adoptive family made a movie, which I saw for the first time when I was about 11. The impact of the film stays with me to this day. The next scene is called The Movie. For the first 3 years of my life, we lived in a duplex upstairs from my father's oldest sister, Molly, and his father, Louis, in a predominantly Jewish neighborhood in the West End of Toledo. I don't remember much about living there, but I do have vivid memories of packing up our belongings and moving to the other, more upscale side of town into a fourplex apartment built by my mother's father, Leo. Although our new apartment was in a better location, it was less spacious and lacked the storage. As a result, the attic was full of boxes that had been wedged into tight space since moving day. Now, 7 years later, during a routine inspection, the fire department declared my parents' attic to be a hazard. I had a dilemma because I was raised Jewish, and so fortunately there was the Day of Atonement, you know, so you could repent. But Kathy Donnelly was my best friend, and she was Catholic, and so she told me that because I was Jewish, I was going to hell. This is not in the book, but... And so I was struggling with, okay, am I damned if I do and damned if I don't? And so I really wanted to be Catholic for a long time. I thought I could say some Hail Marys and I had better chances of being forgiven for this atrocity that I had unwittingly committed. And that was a horrible struggle up until the time I was about 13 and discovered boys and realized I probably wasn't going to hell because I had killed my birth mother. There were other reasons.